described and captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Ambrose Video Publishing Incorporated presents A History of American Indian Achievement, The Emergence of
A title appears over a native dancer dressed in furs and feathers. A History of American Indian Achievement. Now a host is backdropped by the Crazy Horse Monument.
The first half of the 20th century was the worst of times for American Indians. We were a vanishing race. Hello, I'm Tyler Christopher, and welcome to the 7th episode of A History of American Indian Achievement. In spite of these desperate times, two remarkable things happened. The American Indian voice was finally heard by the dominant white culture, and American Indian heroes rose up and showed the world that we were in fact great people.
A title, The Emergence of the American Indian Hero.
In the next two chapters, we shall see how a few heroic Indians with one foot in each culture found ways to be heard and preserve Indian traditions.
Words read, 1883, Sarah Winnemucca publishes her autobiography. A title page features an illustration of a woman carrying a woven basket.
Sarah Winnemucca's autobiography, Life Among the Paiutes, published in 1883, was the first book ever written by an American Indian woman.
Sarah poses in a fringe dress.
Not only one of the most influential and charismatic American Indian women in history, Sarah was also the first American Indian to actively campaign for American Indian rights and protection of their traditions. Born around 1844, Sarah was the daughter of Chief Winnemucca of the Paiutes, a tribe living in Nevada and California. As a young woman, she became involved in a dispute with a local Indian agent, William Reinhardt, who was cheating the Paiutes.
Nobody really knows Indians who cheat them and treat them badly.
Thus began her lifelong fight to improve the treatment of Indians and preserve the identity of her people. Sarah dedicated the last 11 years of her life to fighting for Indian rights. Employing the Paiute's oral tradition, she delivered stirring lectures to whites throughout the country.
For shame, for shame. You dare to cry out liberty when you hold us in places against our will, driving us from place to place as if we were beasts.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.